In this episode, we see family issues between Lestat, Louis, and Claudia. Hello, entertainment enthusiasts. This is Ray, and this is the Fandom Realm. Today, we're looking at episode 5 of Interview with the Vampire. And just as a reminder, this is a spoiler review. Just be warned. Now, this episode is going to follow up episode 4 with Claudia being devastated at the loss of Charlie, basically the guy she really liked that unfortunately she killed. She tried to get Lestat to bring him back and change him into a vampire, but he was stone cold dead, so that wasn't something that was possible. Basically, Louis's going to think that Claudia was staying in her room, staying in her bed, basically in mourning. But in fact, she was actually out killing random people. She was actually not being very responsible. Instead of burning them or getting rid of the bodies permanently, she was actually burying them. Now, that's going to leave traces throughout the town. Eventually, Lestat is going to confront her. She's going to admit that she buried the bodies throughout the city. The bad thing about this is Louis and Lestat both know that the bodies will eventually be found when there is a flood. Basically, the flood water is going to wash all the soil out, and then the bodies would become visible. This is all going to turn out to be true. There's a big rain, a big storm, a number of bodies are found. And with that, the police are going to start investigating the hotels and the different households. They even broke into Louis and Lestat's house. Claudia had been bringing souvenirs from each of her killings. She was actually almost a little serial killer type person. The police are going to not really find any proof against Claudia, Lestat, and Louis. And basically, at this point, Claudia is going to end up leaving the house. We're going to have a time jump. 7 years later, Louis is still grieving for Claudia's absence. Meanwhile, Claudia met with another vampire. That vampire's name was Bruce. And in the beginning, Bruce seemed friendly enough. Claudia seemed to be thinking he was someone she could maybe get to know a little better. But in the end, she's going to understand that he was vicious and basically a evil creature of the night. Now, Louis was trying to contact her with his psychic communication, but Claudia was blocking him. Claudia is going to come back to town. She's going to start following Louis, and he actually went to meet his sister at one point. While he was meeting his sister, Claudia was actually witnessing this meetup. This was basically one of those meetups with his sister where Louis's sister was basically leaving town, and it's going to leave him feeling abandoned. I think this also sort of showed Claudia as well that Louis really wanted her turned because he was looking for that family, especially maybe a sister, and to have that type of support. Claudia comes home, and she is going to ask Louis to leave Lestat and come with her. Lestat is absolutely furious, and he's going to attack Claudia. And then when Louis tries to stop him, they're going to have a huge fight. And this is a pretty good fight throughout the house. It's really sort of showed two vampires fighting. And they had super speed, super power, so you really didn't get to see much of the fight. But everything that was going on in the house was sort of showing you that it was a pretty violent fight. Basically, Claudia isn't going to be able to stop that fight, and Lestat flies off with Louis into the sky. When they fly off, basically the big issue for Lestat here is why can't Louis love Lestat like Lestat loves Louis? And then he just dropped Louis, and he's going to fall. And Louis, of course, he's not dead. We know that because he's talking to the reporter in the future. Claudia was furious. Of course, Louis is not going to be very happy either. And of course, Claudia wants to kill Lestat at this point. Now, just some personal thoughts on this episode. First off, they've been setting up this whole idea of the family and a broken family and issues they might have. I mean, this was shown with Louis and his family. I think also you see the whole problem with this question they've been asking, or at least Louis has been asking, of sort of like, why be a vampire? Could you be a better vampire? And things like that. One other thing in this episode, Lestat, he's been around for a long time. He's much more powerful than Louis, partially because he drinks human blood and Louis drinks animal blood. Louis's never had the passion for Lestat in previous episodes where they were seeing different people. That all comes back to this whole idea of Louis not really loving Lestat. And, even with that, all this links back to the whole idea that Louis isn't happy being a vampire. And in the beginning, he was not really impressed with everything that was going on. And he's been very disappointed over all this time. And then that led to Louis being rejected by his family. And he's going to feel very responsible for everything that's going on. It ended up being that Claudia was sort of very important for Louis. And then when she left for that amount of time, he basically was left with this big void. And although he did have Lestat with him at all times, he couldn't stop thinking about Claudia. And when she came back and wanted to leave with him, basically that's something that Louis considered a good idea. He really had no affection left for Lestat at that point. So that's when basically Lestat's going to realize what's going on. He's basically going to attack Claudia to stop her from doing what he saw as manipulating Louis. That's going to cause your fight. And basically that's what's happening at the end. Just a couple other things. I didn't mention it in the review, but there was an issue when the cops came. They did make an offhanded comment about two men living together. And, I thought that was sort of a way to show that, yes, this was still not something that was acceptable back then. But lots of times people just overlooked things like that. Now, another way they actually showed Louis's feelings for Claudia is with the modern day interview with Daniel Malloy, when Malloy really pushed about some of the writings that Claudia had kept in her diary. She was a sort of a little serial killer, so she actually was writing down what her victims said before they died. And when he was reading through all this, he was really pushing Louis, and Louis actually took control of him. And that's actually a scene I enjoyed because it went into more depth, or at least showed us more of the vampire's powers. And that's something I'm really interested in this show. Now, we're setting up to Claudia is going to have to assist Louis in trying to get rid of Lestat. I'm not exactly sure how this is going to turn out, or at least how the show is going to end up handling this. So that is, of course, going to come in the future. Now let's talk about a rating for this episode of Interview with the Vampire. I enjoyed this episode. I did mention at the end of the last episode that they need to maybe do a little bit more because things had slowed down a little and I was starting to lose interest. Well, just when I said that, this episode picked back up and I'm really with it, I think, for the rest of the season. I'm really interested to see what they do the rest of the season between Louis, Lestat, Claudia, seeing if they actually do come into conflict this season or if that's something they wait on. Again, guys, I am not a book reader on this, so some of you may know what's supposed to happen. I don't, and I like keeping it that way. So, for a grade, I'm going to give this episode probably an A-. There was action. There was some nice dialogue. They moved the story along. I totally enjoyed this episode. I actually am going to go back and watch it again. I don't watch episodes multiple times to do the review. I actually do the review, and then if I have a watch again, I go back through. But I think A- is fair. There really wasn't anything in this episode that I would mark it down for. So that's why I'm giving it an A-. All right, everyone. I hope you enjoy this review. Please hit that subscribe button, like the video, and comment below. And we'll see you next time on the Fandom Realm.